Today we're going to look at changing between A minor and E minor and C major. Each of those chords is derived from the A natural minor scale. The A minor chord has three notes in it, A, C, and E. In this voicing of the A minor chord, I have A, an E, another A, a C, and an E. Let's look at that again. A, root, E the fifth, A the root, C the third, and another duplicated fifth. A minor chord with the root in the lowest voice. When I make the change from A minor to E minor, I pivot on my second finger. So there's no need to lift all the fingers of my hand to make the change to the next chord. This also tells me that these two chords have a note in common. The note that they have in common is the E note. The E minor should also be attacked from its root, in this case on the sixth string. A, E. Now let's add a C major chord, which also is derived from the A natural minor scale. The C major chord also has the E note in common. Therefore, we can pivot on that same note using that same finger between those three chords. Let's do a chord progression of A minor to E minor to C to A minor. See that the second finger didn't move. Now I'd like to discuss a right hand technique that's called pick and drag. 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 From the root of the chord. Pick and drag, pick and drag, pick and drag, pick and drag. That pick and drag technique begins to establish a bass movement as well as striking the notes of the chord at the top, leaving the impression of more than one thing happening at the same time. That's A minor to E minor to C major with the pivot point of the E note underneath finger two, with a pick and drag technique starting from the root of each chord.